Today I have the pleasure of speaking with James Howard Tripp from Stage Zero Life Sciences. How are you today?
I'm good, thank you.
Of course, you have a magnificent following, incredible volume, and you've just announced you've moved into the European markets. Is that correct?
Yep. No, very exciting. We've always been focused just on the US, and so it's really nice to step actually outside of that and into Europe. And Oncopharma came to us, and I think people were not too sure why we were doing the deal, but I think they can see now why. Onco's got a whole set of previous partners that they've worked with, they know where they are, and so this is the beginning. And so you look at what this could potentially do for us over the next few years, it's great, it really is.
And of course, you have made a number of transformations this year, including a name change. I think we were talking earlier that this has impacted your billing and you've wanted to explain this a little bit more thoroughly.
Super question. I think what people did was they've looked at us and they said, well, what on earth's happened to your revenue? And it is because when you change names, you've in actual fact got to cease billing. You've got to apply for a whole new series of numbers, Medicare, tax numbers, everything in sight. They take several months to come through. And once that's through, only then can you begin to restart billing. We've also, that, and we're literally starting now. Over the last couple of weeks, we've been starting now. The good thing of that is we start to see a bolus of revenue into year end. The other thing with this is we've also taken the opportunity to move it in-house. So we will truly be doing it in-house, which just gives us better control over everything. So starting now.
For all of you out there who have done very well in the cannabis market and you're looking to diversify your portfolio in life sciences and you're looking at Stage Zero, James, provide us with some of your real competitive advantages.
Yeah, we're starting to see that. And you know, the really good thing is pushing. So we talked about billing a moment ago. And billing good, but billing takes time. And you're never entirely certain of how much you're going to recover. A very big part of our platform is to move into the patient-directed testing and or telehealth. That's a huge emerging area in the US. Patients want way more control of what they do. They want to control where their dollars go. They want to control how they get their health care. And of course, this is a way for them to begin to get tests done, particularly for early cancer detection that maybe they can't do otherwise. So we've been pushing into this quite strongly and we're starting to lift off. And oh boy, are we starting to lift off. It's amazing to see the numbers as they come in. And so to explain this a little more, for example, over about the last month, we've had over 1 million exposures. That's people to whom our ads have gone and who have looked at the ads, over 1 million exposures. As that starts to translate through, there are those that will come down and download information from you. They give you more information. They also give you permission to actually engage with them, all the way from there down to people that are actually buying the test online. And that truly, as we say, that's the exciting bit. It's really starting to move. And the nice thing too from a billing side is this is cash up front. These people pay up front in terms of where they do. And that's what we're looking for as we drive into the rest of the year.
So James, I know your time, you've been so amazing with your time with your shareholders, and I know you have a lot of them that are interested in Stage Zero. What question do you wish these shareholders would ask you presently?
I think getting a better understanding of the various platforms that we have. So in other words, the four platforms that we have, only one of which is regular billing, three of which are outside of that. So for example, in firefighters, we're continuing, which is an example of a large employer. And we're continuing to build very, very nicely in that. We're becoming, in fact, the go-to group that people go, you know, want their testing done from. I think the second thing is some large healthcare groups, and I think we mentioned that we've signed our first large healthcare group. I don't think people truly believe that because we've seen no real credibility given to it. It will play out in time, and I think then people will see where all of that goes. And then obviously the final piece is telehealth, you know, the patient-directed testing that I just talked about. And if I perhaps just finish that off a little bit, telehealth is huge. Take 1 million people that or a million potential patients that have looked at it. Take thousands that come through that say they would like more information, would like to get engaged, through to those that you actively work with, and then translate that in at the average price that you get on it. You can see the revenue potential that this will generate, and it's cash up front. That for us is what's so exciting. You then go to the science. We're still the group that we believe can find cancer earlier than anyone else. And so Aristotle, more questions on Aristotle would be the other thing. And so Aristotle, we have proof of principle at this point. We talk about proven, not promised. I think as we're getting inquiries out there as to people who want to work with us, that's where it is. We can find 10 cancers off of a single sample of blood, and we're way ahead of everyone else in terms of the science. That's, I think, where the excitement is.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. As always, it's a pleasure.
You're very welcome.